So I think we are live now.
Yes, Sunny, go ahead.
Thank you so much. So good morning, good afternoon, good evening to audience watching from India, different parts of India, and to the international audience who are going to watch us on different social media platforms. I'm really, really charged, happy, and I've come with a beautiful topic and with some great secrets, which is going to make happy parenting and happy parents and happy kids. And it's very easy, you know. I'm seeing my mother, I've seen my sisters do a great job. Yes, I know it is tough. It's a 20-year project, not paid. And all of a sudden we get married, we don't come to know. We fall in love, we get married, and in no time we have kids. So this is the story, and we become parents. And then there's no training, formal, okay, come, there's a project and degree, 3-year course, come, we'll teach you parenting. It just happens. So we must learn from nature. Nature, mother, those are real leaders, givers. And then they help us blossom. So it's a beautiful blessing, a gift from God. Let's fulfill this beautiful responsibility. Because children are angels, children are God. And great leaders like Dr. Kiran Bedi, they don't see kids as kids, they see them as generations. She runs 2 foundations and she's doing amazing work. She's giving them education, holistic education, character education, value education, skill-based education. Not just those correspondence degrees, BA, and you know, in Delhi, we have BA pass. One is BA honors. And nothing happens after that. So, as parents, let's apply the 3H formula, head, heart, and hands. Head refers to knowledge, heart refers to values, and hands refer to the skills. 3S formula in Hindi, Shiksha, Sanskar, and Skills. Right? So Midna Global is doing a great job sharing super secret mantras, awareness programs in schools, colleges, these days online. So we need to be thankful to Midna Global, to Ratnaswami sir, who has so much of content based on neuroscience. His 80,000 scans, he's helped so many children. Right? So let's go ahead and learn the secret. So to begin with, I have some fun and joy. Simple tips, which you will love. ABCD of parenting. A is the first letter. So only one word, just be aware. Aware about what? Aware about my own self. Am I strict with them? Always scolding them. And all the communication is, come, eat. Or bossing, get up. Why did you do this? Do it properly. You did well, but... So I need to be aware of myself, my tone, my behavior, my emotions, and love is giving. Am I aware? Am I aware, you know, of my kids, their abilities? I'll be talking about it later. Their learning styles, their memory, their talents. So I need to walk the talk. I need to be aware of my actions. So this awareness is important. You know what? Let's go ahead. Let's start believing in them. Let's believe every child is a genius. Let's believe that my child is wow, is an avatar, is a gift of God, is born to shine like Tatas, Narayana Murthy's, Dr. Kiran Bedi. And am I balancing life? B is the second letter, so two words, believe and balance. So balance is important. Don't always, you know, be after them, bulldozing them. Let there be work and play. Love. You want to discipline them, great. But balance. It's okay. 5 days, you discipline. 2 days, love them. Tell it in different style. Think of a reward system. Don't always be, you know, with a stick. Have a carrot also. So now, in the name of caring, we pamper them. My child should not face what I faced. And there are parents, before the child asks, it is given. And you know, we do brain profiling for ministers' kids and all. They say, look, my child has two maids. One in the left, one in the right. Anything falls, it is picked up. So where are we going? Sir beautifully says, Ratna Swami, sir, poverty is the best MBA. So prepare them, care for them, but don't pamper them. Oh, you don't want to eat? It's okay. 2 minute noodles. Wait for 2 minutes. Then where will the child eat healthy food? I'm also addicted to mobile. You also be addicted to mobile. Let's pamper each other's desires. Let's play online games only. 7 days. No. Let's go outdoors also. After Corona. Right? So let's commit. Parenting is commitment. Parenting is joy. It is not always pinpointing, I did this for you. Then that is not love. Right? Let us sacrifice, but love is equal to sacrifice. Love is being happy in the happiness of the beloved. Love is caring, concern. Right? And be careful. Don't fight in front of them. Use right words. Right? So let us leave positive imprints. And remember, they are following you. They do what you do. They will not do what you say. Right? So D is the fourth letter. And we have four. So let us decode. What is in their brain? Let us discover. Wow! Gifts! Put them into activities. See them blossom. Design their life. And let them live their destiny. You don't sit and worry. What will happen? How will it happen? The way you are taken care for 20, 30, 40, 50 years, your children and grandchildren are also given diamond destiny. Okay. It's a fully paid world tour for everyone. And now the E, 5 E's. Encourage, engage, empathize, experience, enjoy. Now tell me, are we encouraging? You know what? When we should encourage? Somebody said, this word of praise and encouragement is not required when we are succeeding. But it is required when I am failing. You may tell stories. Wow, Sunny. I don't need it. When I am alone, when I have failed, when I am sad, when I have done a mistake, when I have committed serious blunder, then I need my tall genie Ratnaswami sir to hold my hand, to touch my shoulder and say, it's okay. And he is one, he'll do it. Because he loves everyone. Right? And when I win prizes, whole world is clapping. Then I don't need you, right? Think. I'm already happy. There are already happy hormones dancing in me, right? So when you should encourage, I'm there for you. Go. Explore. I'm always there for you. That trust, that belief, that bonding, you know, it happens when we are nurturing ourselves, when we are raising our bar. And are we engaging with them? Are we engaging their talents? Or study maths, no sports, no dancing, no guitar. 10th standard only, they need it more. How will the stress go? No. 10th standard, everything cut off. See, this is a beautiful lesson. 10th exam cancelled, 12th exam cancelled. Will those children not shine in life? Will only exam decide everything? Think. No. It's the character, it's the values, it's the concepts, it's the skill set, expertise. It's a commitment to learn, being a good student, being a lifelong learner. Are we instilling by engaging with them and empathize? You know, my teenage nephew says, mother says, you tell us whatever it is, you tell us. And then in telling, we bulldoze. What have you done? Why have you done? And the child is gone. The teenager is cornered. Then why did you say, you tell us? You should share with parents. See, this is a teenage issue. I was just writing down what is there in their heart. Make life a beautiful experience. Gift your children a great experience, a joyful memory. And why not for yourself? Create memories. Let your heart sing. Let us discover joy every heartbeat. That is my favorite line these days. And that will make life joy. And we can enjoy. But you know what? Life has changed. My parents were happy parents. Cool dad and cool mom. Now, there is cutthroat competition these days. Technology, iPhone, iPad. So much competition. We also had, no? But now there is more, they say. Okay. And we can't even understand this latest social media, Snapchat and WhatsApp. We don't even know. TikTok. Some of them understand, modern parents. But my parents still don't understand. And some of them are in villages. Their children know everything. Parents don't know. And the magic. I studied in, you know, matriculation school. It was just 2,000 rupees per term and, you know, 5,000 or 6,000 per year. Today, it is 3 lakhs per year. The cost of education has gone up. Both parents working. Still, no international holiday. Flights are, cancelled now. Countries have shut the doors. No entry. People are waiting to go out. So life is beautiful, yeah. Life has changed. And all has changed for good. I'm only telling some challenges, some new things that has changed from my time to the young modern times. From my grandfather's time to the new times. And you know what? Earlier there was only engineer doctor. Boy means engineer, IIT, IIM. And then girl means doctor. Otherwise, girl should get married after 18. Finished. That was happening. But now, girls have achieved. Gone up to Mount Everest. Moon. And so many engineers, so many world-class CEOs, right? So you see, there is so much improvement, magic, enhancement, empowerment, and lot of cases, girls earn more than boys. So many career options also. AI, IoT, I don't even know the full forms. NLP, natural language learning, natural language processing, Internet of Things, and then there is some data analytics. Big data, small data, tiny data. So many things we don't understand. And then the social media, SEO, digital marketing, Google Analytics. And today in lockdown, everyone is a coach. Failure coach, fear coach. I'm not joking. I'm very serious. And it is good. We have so many coaches around us. Growth coach, money coach, millionaire mindset coach, resilience coach. There are many coaches. So there are options available. There is help available. But I am still confused what to do. And Ratnaswami sir says, guide. So I will tell you the secret in the last. How to guide. How to make life easy. But now let's talk about careers. I like to dance. But I'm not talented. I've gone for 4 years and failed. Not done well. I like to dance. And in my tradition and culture, they say, boys should not dance. What will a dancer do? There is no scope. Somebody was telling me, what teacher, teacher, teacher? There is no growth for teacher. I said, okay. But then I did not stop because I am a teacher, you know. So teacher trainer, teacher assessor, quality auditor in schools, right? So there is scope if you are born to do it. Chapter 3, Bhagavad Gita. If you are following your Swadharma, if you're finding your Ikigai, the Japanese copied from Bhagavad Gita, huh? That is the magic. So now, what do I do? Like I said, 10th standard, we focus on marks. Father wants marks. Mother says, go, go, dance, dance, dance. I could not become a Bharatanatyam dancer. You become a Bharatanatyam dancer. We want our dreams to be fulfilled through them. Father says, become a lawyer. Mother says, become a doctor. Become an IAS. And we are forcing them to get into those exams where so many lakhs get inside and only one small 100 succeed. So who is making a child failure? Who is giving that failure mindset? Think. So we are only running after results. 96, 99. Some parents are cool. Those are rare few. let the child do whatever they want to do. But you can't leave it like that. So that is why this session, how can we parent smartly? And then relationship stress, relationship with self. I'm not happy with myself. Corona, sitting at home, and no favorite vegetables are coming at home. We have to search for vegetables and they are costly. And we are complaining all the time. When I'm not happy with myself, can I give joy to my husband or spouse or wife or mother-in-law or father-in-law? And some of them are having additional guests in this lockdown. Think. Relationship stress. And not just this. Forget. Parents never understand the children. Children never understand the parents. And we do this teen parent workshop bonding, you know. There, for the first time, teenager is asking, Amma, what do you love? How was your teenage? Then Amma gets excited and both are crying. Those are bonding workshops. Do we do this simple questionnaire? Talking to each other about childhood and, you know, understanding feelings, hugging each other, telling, I love you, I'm sorry, I'm thanking you. Three things. We never say this. Tell this to yourself. Moving ahead. And children have also become modern. We were lucky. We scored well. We enjoyed our childhood. Playing the gully cricket. Losing balls. And then friend telling, you should buy me a ball. Huh? Because you lost my ball. And then we have to go to the mother and say, Amma, give me money and I have to go to buy ball for the other person. All this happened. And whole day. Saturday means whole day on the road. They have to call and we have to just go and eat and come back. And we are playing. What a great childhood. Now it is greater. With technology, child prodigies. Great. But the challenge. Addiction is not okay. An addiction to wrong things is not okay. Addiction to social media is not okay. I went to a spiritual organization. I was talking to a monk. I said, what, sir? What, Swamiji? No children. He said, in your days, there were no Facebook and malls. Now, teenagers have Facebook and malls. True, no? Correct. So my God, some of us are indoor, some of us are outdoor. Some of us want to be pulled by parents and pushed. So some of us want to be pulled outside, some of us want to be pulled inside. What do? We are different. And peer influences become high. All my friends have iPhone and Macintosh. I have Android only. And not just peer influence this. Today flights are cheaper. Everybody goes to Singapore. I go only to Ooty. And then I have to show, no, I went there. So false low self-esteem, false showing off of high self-esteem, feeling inferior and superior, both are egos. Both are forms of some stupidity which lead to problems. And then adolescent stress, anger and hormone and all. And then the puppy love. She's so beautiful. Think. And then teachers scolded me in front of everyone. Teachers are biased. What all? You can't even imagine what our teenagers talk. What our teenagers think. And they think, you know, this LGBT and all that should be legalized. So they are thinking at that level and their mind is going there. They want to know why school, why exam, No, these questions are not addressed by anyone. Parents, no time. Parents, they don't talk also. They don't share also. Because there's no bonding. There's no rapport. There's no connection. And teachers don't have time. Syllabus, 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 syllabus. Sadly, LKG also has syllabus. LKG teachers is also sitting like this, doing activity. And there is no time to free talk, heart-to-heart talk, emotional intelligence talk, bonding period. It should be there. Emotional intelligence classes. Nothing doing. Schools are busy. If we hire trainers, we have to pay and spend. If we hire at home, one more expense. That is not required. You go and play cricket. How will you face failure? Performance pressure. And then the great grandparents. Mother scolds, father comes and saves. Father scolds, grandparents also. Don't scold. Did we scold you like this? And we saved the children. When will we teach rules? When will we balance, you know, chapati cooking? It is not just love. And it is not just punishment. It is both sides. The same mother that slaps says, oh, la, 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 la. Why did you beat if you had to love? You won't understand. That is the secret. You make the child realize. And then you love also. This is the magic of parenting. Anyways, this is life. We have to manage. We have to be aware of these challenges. So now what do I do? I have become an adult, adolescent. I'm so confused. And I'm doubting also. And I don't have support. Concrete. Right? Which route to take? Did I make the right choice? Mother is forcing one thing. Father is forcing one thing. 11 standard subject choices. Principal also says, if you want to change, we are there. Schools also don't know the art and science of ikigai, of neuroscience, of the inborn traits, inborn personality. Think. Let's move ahead. And the one who is scoring zero is labeled. He is weak, sir. He doesn't know anything. He may be playing great guitar. He may be a great chef. He may be a great artist. He may be a great sculpturist. Think, what are we doing? Where are we going? And if you go into a school and ask, how many of you are intelligent? Hardly 2-3 will raise a hand. Think, it is actually a painful state. Let us make our children believe they are wonders, they are diamonds, they are priceless gems. They are geniuses. They are leaders. That's it. I think you have done your job. Seriously. Kiran Bedi ma'am beautifully says, ma'am, what is one value we should give to the children? You know what she answered? Self-confidence. Why? If the child has confidence, he will attempt to learn, he'll attempt to do, and he'll become a successful person. He'll do other things, good things, and he'll pick up other skills and values. So that's important. So we are all different, but what is happening in the school? Same question paper, same evaluation style, not understanding that every 40 brains in front of me are different. Their brain processing speed is different. Their grasping speed is different. Their output speed is different. their style of learning is different, their memory is different. What are we doing? Same question paper, same style. And we label them also. Yes, I understand there are challenges. I can't change school. I can't change the system. But don't label your child. You don't force your child. You don't give stress to your child. Right? So now the question is, same teacher, same class, same syllabus. Then why do children not perform the same way? Smart classroom has come. Still children are not smart. Teachers, parents, children, I don't know who is smart in between these. Think, do we know our children? Do we know our child's personality? Obedient, flexible, diplomatic, adamant. Easy and intuitive learner. I understood, sir. Or a sensory learner. Show me, explain to me. Am I a left brainer or a right brainer? Think. So let's quickly do a small quiz. And we don't have a manual also, you know, like SIM card also has a manual. Everything comes with a manual. Children don't come with a manual. Parenting, there are no manuals. There are only books with personal opinions, personal experiences. But every child is unique. Every brain is unique. So everything doesn't work for everyone. And I've seen so many career counselors. They just guide based on interest. What about talent? Yeah. What about inborn skill, which is coming effortlessly? If it is not coming, I'm sure it is going to be a disaster. Just because I'm interested in music, I'm telling you, whether it is Facebook or YouTube, when I start singing, everybody will quit. Because I need to have swara, love for music, talent, sense, music sense, tune sense, tonality, pitch. I understand nothing of it. So that is what it is. So I give you a few minutes to just glance. Self-learning, study preference, interest, behavior, skill, learning speed, working with, self-management, decision-making, or suitability. NLP calls this neuro-linguistic programming. They've done a lot of research, they say. Our brain has meta programs, and these programs are different. There are so many psychometric tests. They also don't guide properly. My child is not interested. My nephew's paper was lost. My nephew was having fun, and they did A, B, 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 C, 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 C. And it was in school. It was a paid test. All parents paid 2,500. Reputed psychometric career counseling agency. And some of them are really confused because options look same. Some of them cannot understand full English. Places like Bihar, UP. Forget Bihar, UP. What do you think about Delhi slums? What do you think about Delhi first generation learners? What do you think about a class of 500 children where they are taking psychometric tests? Is help available to understand every question? Are teachers having patience? Is it logistically also possible to guide 500 children at a time? Think. And if I am confused, I feel this also. Sometimes this, sometimes that. Think. So, psychometric test also is only a hint, right? Now, so many questions to be answered. Which curriculum is good? There are so many schools. Which school is good? Why so many curriculums, state board, CBSC, ICSC? Simple. It is a deep meaning. State board is the easiest. CBSC is level 2. ICSC level 3. IB is level 4. In terms of their knowledge, application, self-learning styles, research, etc. Auditory, visual, kinesthetic. Three styles of learning. They are inborn. But how do I find? Okay, you may guess. But then, should I not develop the other? Should I not balance it and increase the duration of study and make it effective and make it wow? Otherwise, children sleep in class. I bet you, some of you must have slept in class, even in the room, who are listening to me now. Sunny, oh, some visual simulation is there in the PPT and some nice voice. And I can appreciate you. You are a wonderful audience. So am I motivating you? Effective people, cognitive, am I giving you good stuff? Intelligent stuff to process, logical talk, reflective, am I repeating or am I going too fast? Am I giving you instructions? Think. So what is the catalyst motivating me? Which subject do I take? What do I do in college? I may do engineering, but I may land up in HR because I love people. Yes, I'm good in science, but my core is HR or my core is marketing. How do I identify that? So all these are question marks. And don't do hit and trial. We don't have time to waste child's precious energy. We don't have time and right to give stress to children. Little stress is good, but don't give too much of stress with all these confusions. Right? Career, which chair to sit, which department, which cluster, which industry. I may do engineering, but I can become a professor also. Chalo, engineering padhao. Engineering professor, teacher. Because my heart lies in helping. By mistake, I took the science and machine and engineering subjects. Because my father forced for his status and name and fame. Right? So many questions, multiple intelligences, IQ, EQ, CQ. You know, intellectual quotient, emotional quotient, creativity quotient, adversity quotient, all this can be decoded just like this. And it is so important. Why? IQ is okay, you get a job, you get marks. EQ for family, EQ for managing teams, AQ to manage failure, adversity quotient, strength to face life, CQ to become a leader. Think. Are we truly aware? Are we truly super parents? Think. And these intelligences, should I have wonderful hobbies? Should I balance my life? Or should I just run after money, 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 wealth, 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 wealth? And like all great leaders have said, Dalai Lama Ji has said, you lose health with the wealth you earned because you ran after it, right? This is so important. And then the personality types, diplomatic, cognitive, reflective, effective, thinker or a feeler, loving, caring, or the freedom fellow who likes no control, whether you tell softly, whether you tell logically. I have decided my way or highway. We need people like that because they become great entrepreneurs. They are risk takers. They are change makers. Nothing is bad. I am not saying any personality is bad. Any style is bad because all has its own advantage. Everything is a boon and a bane. And excess is anyways poison. Huh? It's not told by me, it's told by Vivekananji. Right? So life is a balance. Are we balanced parents? Answer yourself. Don't answer me. Because you may answer goody-goody to me. To look good, to appear good, to show good. And we all want to show our super duper good side with mask and all. But you don't sleep with the mask. You remove it. You remove the makeup after marriage functions. You don't sleep with your shoes on. Be you. And enjoy your self-growth journey. Raise yourself. And there is so much in the brain. I think this is a beautiful awareness session. Let's get aware, that's all. It's not for scaring you. Left brain, right brain, this, that. No. Yes. Brain is a gift. Brain is a beautiful 3D gadget. Let's use it. And not lose it. And not die with a song in our heart. Let us help our children blossom. A great master wrote, children are not vessels to be filled. They are lamps to be lit. Let us help our children grow and glow. Let them be a candle that lights up, gives light to all who pass through. He's a Muslim. He's a Christian. He is this. He is dark. He is small. He is short. No. Whoever passes, give love, humanity, interdependence, global family, Vasudeva Kutumbakam, giver, sacrificer, one who serves. Tata served, gave us salt, and they became millionaires. Tatas gave us car, they became heroes. Tatas gave us software, they became global leaders. Think, Infosys gave software to the whole world. They also have become world-class leaders. So if you want your children to be leaders, they should be givers. And you should identify these so that they succeed with satisfaction, with joy, not with overstress and sweat. Sweat and stress is good, but in a limit. It should not take you to ICU beforehand. We should not invite diseases, Dr. Kiran Bedi says. Invited deaths. Right? So the right values, the right management style, the right psychometric tests, the right personality we need to know so that we pair and parent. So first we become good parents. So now how to decode all this? Do you all want a personalized manual? All of us want. All of us want manual for self. What a joy to know self. Knowing self is enlightening. Knowing your spouse is very enlightening. Right? And knowing your children is a boon. And Midna Global gives a personalized manual. Not any parenting book. Not any Gyan book. Look, handle your children like this. They don't know your children. And psychometric tests also were made 200 years ago. They were made in Europe, in America. Not in a UP Bihar village. Think. And in India, with so much of variety, Kerala, Tamil Nadu mindset, Karnataka mindset, Andhra mindset, you think psychometric tests will work? There are challenges. I'm not saying they are bad. Everything is good. They are tools. But this is the most reliable way. And you will see Dr. Kiran Bedi's testimonial on YouTube. And you will see so many parents who have benefited, so many children who have benefited with the personalized manual. And that's magic. So how does this all happen? What do we do? There is no magic. It is just like buying a lady's finger, buying a jackfruit. How many fruits are there? So there is a connection between brain and fingerprints. How you learn to buy fruits and vegetables, you can know your brain also today. So when we are in mother's womb, between 13th to 24th week, fingerprints and brain develops simultaneously. And we become geniuses. God, nature sows the seed of genius. And today we can decode all behavior traits, all I spoke about, intelligences, brain processing, speed, learning styles, and we give you a beautiful manual. So now a quick comparison. Like psychometric tests, multiple questionnaires. Here there is no questionnaire in brain profiling. Psychometric test is subjective. Evaluators, mindset, teacher mindset, student mindset. Student is not happy. My mother has forced me. My mother scolded me. My heart broke. My love failed. And I failed yesterday. I lost a match. So subjective and objective. Then psychometric test above 12 years. Below 12 years, you can't do it. And I will not manipulate. I'll be innocent. After 12, I can manipulate. Because I know I'm being tested. What do you do? Do you get angry? Sometimes. I will not say always. Agree, disagree, slightly agree, slightly disagree. In this also, there is so much of confusion for people like me. So brain profiling can be done as early as 1 year old or 2 year old. Psychometric test is time consuming. Genetic brain profiling can be done in 10 minutes. No questions asked. No biases, nothing. Psychometric test is highly variable. Moods, comprehension abilities, so many factors. As I said, UP, Bihar examples. Brain profiling is highly consistent. Whether you do it from any person, result will be the same. The mastery lies in decoding the understanding. Psychometric test can be manipulated. Brain profiling cannot be manipulated. So we have 20 parameters, 20 psychometric tests done in 20 minutes. That is the magic. So this is the most beautiful gift for self. Then spouse. Then kids. Because first is my feelings. My understanding. My growth, my transformation, then family transforms. So brain profiling is giving us so many details. And trust me, the smallest detail, one detail alone can make you a happier person, can make you a joyful parent. Can make you a peaceful soul. Because you realize my design is like this. I am living default. When I am not changing, I stop changing others. I stop getting disturbed by others' behavior. Because I get a realization. This person is like this. And there is greater harmony at home between parents, kids, that this behavior is because of this and this person is not this behavior. Behavior is situational. Behavior is this particular moment. He is a divine soul. He is a genius. Let's focus on the strengths. Let's work on what he is great at. Not pinpoint and make him feel low with his weaknesses. All great people became great by using their strengths. They overcame, they managed, they balanced the not so developed areas, the so-called weaknesses. But if you don't know the strengths, then your life is going to be walking in the dark, shooting in the dark, going somewhere without goals, and you achieve no goals. So my request is, we have a tall genie, a great Swami, Ratna Swami sir, who is humble, who is the father of this project, who is giver of all the knowledge, who coined this word genetic brain profiling, who is well read, who is a neuroscientist, who has worked with the best of organizations in India, the greatest organizations. He's a magician. He can help us a lot. He talks on great topics like brain and happiness, brain and parenting, brain and pairing, brain and business, brain and careers, brain and learning, brain and life coaching. So this is real life coaching. Not the other life coaching programs where they don't quantify your minutest things like introversion, extroversion. Why does the spouse say, leave me alone? Think, I want my time. And then she's back to normal. Small things, if we can understand, life is beautiful. So what is the process? First comes the inquiry. I ask, what am I? Why am I like this? Why my child is behaving like this? We do the scan. We do the analysis. We do the report. Then we guide. And then life is excellent. We start doing what we love. We start understanding self. And I've written a small book, which I love the title, Know Self, Love Self, Celebrate Self. Life should be a celebration, not a drag, not a push, not filled with complaints. So let's start learning and teaching, moving to coaching, and then earn, and then pair. If you change the order, if you pair in school itself, then there'll be problems. After earning, you go for pairing, and very important, after pairing, we should go for parenting. So parenting is raising yourself before raising your kids. Very simple and easy. The great wise spiritual masters have made life easy. Okay. So these two sessions after, sir, pairing and parenting, I'm sure you had a great time. I want to thank each one of you for being there on various platforms. Now over to sir for a quick summary. Any feedbacks, comments, you can unmute yourself and share as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Sunny, for the exhaustive smart parenting session. Yes, in the 21st century, only a smart parent can handle children with less accidents. Because children are few decades advanced in terms of their neurological evolutions. So it is not an easy task to raise children. And with the 21st century moving very fast, it is going to become all the more challenging to have opportunities that would make the whole parenting experience worth remembering and relishing during our later part of our life. Most of the time, parents regret for not having handled the child in the way. After seeing the children performing, then they realize that whatever we tried wasn't not the great thing that we could have done. So parents live their later part of the life. Neither children are happy with the parenting. Even the parents are not happy with the parenting they have done. So if anyone interested in not going through that pain, definitely genetic brain profiling is the only solution for a great experience as a parent. So I think you spent almost 1 hour in going through the whole of art of parenting and the science of parenting. So science of parenting means having a tool, a data, an understanding, technical information to understand the child and apply that information by knowing what will work with the child and how to execute the ideas and the inputs that are received from the genetic brain profile. So if any of the audience have something to say, feedback, I would be happy. And maybe over a period of time, we are more likely to have more parents for this session. Hopefully, after this lockdown, we'll be able to reach schools and communicate to the teachers and the parents about this magical tool. And we'll be able to bring in more. And just now we have started this whole initiative of bringing awareness to the parents and young children so that when they become parents, they would definitely understand the benefit and the usefulness of having this map, brain map of their children, so that they can go through the parenting experience much, much easier and much better. Okay, so any of you have any questions to ask, you can ask. I'll wait for 2 minutes. Otherwise, we can wind up this session. And tomorrow, again, 3 o'clock and 4 o'clock, we have a session. So do join tomorrow if you have nothing more to add as a feedback for this session. Yes, I hope if Bala has gone through the session and you must have got some idea about the whole process. So if you are interested in going through this process, you can message to us. If you are interested in going through the training program that is monthly conducted, that also you can ask us. You can become a consultant, a mentor, and a trainer using this tool. Every walk of our life, this tool can shed a new understanding, new insight of the whole program activities that we are doing. So we'll be more than happy to help you in this endeavor. Okay, so if you have nothing to add, we can sign off this session and meet tomorrow 3 o'clock with 2 more new topics that will be shared in the WhatsApp group by tomorrow morning. Thank you very much.
Sir?
Take care. Yeah, yes.
Sir, good evening, sir. Just one question. So everybody who talks about the tool, they actually speak I mean, a lot of things that they say, it comes across as a very in-depth analysis of the personality, the
Yeah,
skills,
yeah,
etc.,
yeah,
right? So
yeah.
would all those details be available in the report, sir, or somebody has to, I mean, the mentor or the consultant has to tell us, break the report down and explain
the, the report will have the data.
Okay.
It will tell you how many percentage of this activity, this personality, this trait and this interest and this competency. All those parameters will be given as data, as numbers. Maybe if you wish, you can contact me or anyone else. We would like to even give you a glimpse of one report. That report will have only data. I think parents cannot understand it because this whole concept is new.
That report, sample report I saw.
Sir. Yeah, yeah. So the consultant or the counselor will have to convert the data into conversation.
Okay,
because that will be in English. So sometimes you may have to tell it in your the language that the customer can understand. And because this is data, only people who have gone through the training would understand. So there is a coach, there is a mentor, there is a counselor who will convert the data into a useful conversation. And depending upon the customer's design, customer's design means customer's personal choices. For example, some people will enjoy looking at the data, the report, they'll understand a lot. We call them as visual children, visual people. For some people, they'll not understand the data only. They want us to hear from us. So they will enjoy the conversations and the interactions. So without knowing that, we cannot just give them a report to them and say, go and read yourself, you'll be able to understand. That's not an easier thing.
Okay.
And the consultant or the mentor would have had hundreds of scans interpreted. So their expertise, because remember here, every child is a new version. It is not the same child will not, same report will, you will not get two reports same. So every report is going to be different. So to understand the different report, there must be some interpreter is there. So I call them more like an interpreter of the report. And subsequently, they can mature into become a mentor. So that's why we call them as consultants. So first you consult, you give your opinion about the report. And then if you are an experienced person, you can also give them some solutions, some follow-up methods, some guidelines, and some improvising techniques, or maybe some support, resource support and all you can give, so that they not only have the diagnosis, they also can treat, they can also improvise on the challenges. It is not that every individual will have opportunities and threats, both will be there. Challenges will be there, and it will be some plus points also will be there. So we need to know how to create that clarity in the parents or in the child's mind. And that's very interesting and very bit of complex. So that's the reason why we have three levels of training, and 1, 2, 3 like that. And once you come to the second level itself, you will be so competent enough to interpret all kinds of reports on your own. Yeah, otherwise also, company or the office provides a support towards all the counseling challenges. It is there. Always there is a support that is given for any report. The consultants can take the help from the experts and then go and discuss it. Even customer can be asked to directly, participate in the interaction if that is needed. So we give all ample opportunities for the 100% clarity of the data that is given in the report. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sir. But how do we record this conversation? Because it's going to be a conversation, right? So in future, if you want
you
to...
You can ask the customer to use their recorder in the mobile phone and record them. You can also record and keep it. It's your choice.
Okay.
You can record.
And if I do it for my daughter now, say she's in grade 8, and then after 2 years, I have some doubts on the report. Can we go back to the...
Yeah. This report is one-time solution. It is like a land document, original document, the mother document. Okay, you can always refer to the mother document and have clarity on any aspect of it related to the, to the child. Because fingerprints are not changing, the original default settings will not change. Now, some acquired skills would have come, but without the original setting, the acquired one will not be there. You can only improve on it. You cannot change it. That is the message.
Okay.
So it's a one-time assessment and a lifetime solution. That is why we call it as life coaching. You can travel with the child as long as the child wants your support as a life coach. That is the message.
Okay, sir. I have one more question. Yeah. So children, when we can interpret this, you said, as young as 5 years? For the
yes, or as early as 1 year. We have done for children 9-11 months also.
Okay, but the environment plays a huge role, right, sir, in terms of developing the so many of
Bala, even then, the bitter gourd will not give you tomato. The bitter gourd will not change into tomato.
Okay.
The basic tendencies will never change. That's whatever you say, environment, everything will only polish some qualities. You can imbibe some basic qualities, but it is not that you can change the originals. It's like a building. Once you have blueprint, you have built a house. Now you can only do some renovation, not innovation. You cannot change the whole structure. You have to destroy it completely and then only you have to change. So, but definitely you can change the color. You can put some elevation tiles and you can put some gardening and all those things. They are all, what I call it as minute changes that you can do.
Okay. So whether they do it at 1 year or whether they do it at 70 years, you're saying the report will...
The report will remain same, but you would have missed the opportunity to work on the child or anything. That is the only thing. It is like using the Google map after going to the house.
Yeah, last session you said that 7th or 8th grade would be the right time.
That is...
Actually, even
that
earlier, is, but for the to opt for the subject and for the
yes,
career.
Yes, yes okay. I think one can do, but knowing them early is always a good idea so that you know whether you need to get stressed up or you can just relax. What is your role as a parent, you can identify only when you know the child. So earliest is, in my opinion, before putting it to play school, nursery. The minute at the outside home somebody is going to treat the handle the child, I think they should be told that my child prefers this, she will not enjoy this, so don't worry about it. You just give your do your role. No need to make a complaint to me because I understand the child's challenges much better.
Okay.
Otherwise, you will listen to complaints and finally you will say, Yeah, I think every teacher has told my child is doing this, so that means that the problem with the child. Mm-hmm. It takes so much time for us to validate. When everybody says your child is very naughty, then we agree he is naughty, like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I think instead of that, we can always have a proactive, decision. And many a times, some children will be good with extracurricular activities. Some children will not do it. It is not a good idea to go and buy the project from outside and give it to the school. You are cheating yourself only. The child is not going to get anyway benefited because of that. It is better that whatever the child is doing, we should be able to tell the teacher the child has challenges. She is doing certain other things well, but we will motivate the child to do well as much as possible. So the role of the parent, the role of the strength and the challenges of the children, if it is known, I think we will not. It will not get stressed up about things that the child is not able to do easily. They able to.
Yes, okay. Sir. That will be very helpful for parents. So
yes,
I'll do
yes.
it this month for my daughter and for myself.
Yeah. Please.
Thank you.
I think you live in Chennai, right?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. I think Bhuvana is there. You can.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes. I'll get
to her.
In touch.
Yeah. Please. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
I had already spoken to Bala.
Okay.
And,
thank you.
She said she'll come after the lockdown is over.
Yeah.
And
yes.
In fact, I invited her to join as a consultant also.
Yeah. Because she is already.
She mentioned about the course. Yes.
It is so simple, so easy. It is only the learning happens with more and more scans. So the investment that is there is so simple and so minimal. And I want everybody, I made it very simple to come in so that people should go through the experience and feel more blessed and more beneficial rather than making it very costly and very difficult for people to come in. I don't want to make it to look very difficult to reach and approach. So that is the strength also, that that has its also. But I don't know, my style is take minimum and deliver delight. That's my personal choice. Okay.
I had so many questions in my mind only after listening to Kritika last week. She spoke about her daughter also. So much of in-depth analysis from the reports, I don't know. For me, that was very surprising. And the kind that's, of... So how
like
would...
This, like this, every consultant in Midna has a similar experience. You can go to Wow Midna YouTube. You will have 40, 50... such as this thing, maybe you have free time, you can go. But I think everyone who has tasted genetic brain profiling and got little deep on it, maybe the parents who are coming for the assessment, they are just one day coming to a hotel and eating some food and going kind of thing. But the consultants, because day in and day out, they go through a lot of delights, enlightenment on their customers and clients. I think personally speaking, the enlightenment that gives more a lot of blessing and satisfaction rather than the money part of it, which anyhow comes in. I think it's a quite reasonably kept and yes, it is it gives you a lot of satisfaction. That's why I consider in the whole planet, if you consider one profession, that would be the ultimate profession for everyone. Beyond even the medical doctor and all kinds of professors, this consultant or connecting with genetic brain profiling is the most rewarding profession in the planet. That's my personal conviction. And I am yet to see any other profession that is better than this. Okay, because...
Definitely, sir. I think more they interpret for others, I think they understand themselves also better. Otherwise...
Yes. That is
the... If somebody asks me to talk about myself in depth, honestly, more than 5 minutes or 7 minutes, I wouldn't know what to say. But for 1 hour, she could talk about her... So many of her inner strengths and skills and personality and all that.
Yeah. That's the beauty. That's why I say, by treating a patient, doctor does not become healthy. By teaching a child, a teacher does not become super intelligent, except some familiarity comes in the subject. Okay, but with genetic brain profiling, after every counseling, you are evolving into a better human being by default, even if you don't even pay attention. You are going through. All your life challenges will become so simple and manageable. When you see a lot of children and the parents are going through even more difficult challenges in their life. Okay, and please remember, this is not judgment. We are not just based on our personal choices coming to any conclusion. That is why I want to call this as divine script. This is a nature script. Only the language is not familiar. So, Midna does the conversion of the divine script into a manuscript. And then the magic is done. That's it. Okay.
Sure, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. And we have a family meeting, the Midna family meeting. So we are signing out now and joining in the private Zoom session. Thank you, everyone. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.